Hey, what is up, everybody? This is Stevie Beach coming to you here. I found a list of the Andre the Giant Memorial Battle Royal competitors for WrestleMania 35. When it comes to making the WrestleMania videos, the Andre the Giant Memorial Battle Royal is honestly one of my favorite videos to make because of the fact that you just get to sort of go through the list of competitors and every once in a while pull up a name like No Way Jose and just say for, hey, I really like No Way Jose. I kind of don't like his new look, but he is one of those guys that when he comes out on Monday Night Raw, that entrance, you know, makes me smile and sort of gets me into a groove. And, you know, they don't do a lot of things with audience participation, which was one of my favorite things about the Attitude Era, that I think that if they found a way to bring those things back, just like, you know, add something to the entrances, to the competitors, sort of like, with the New Age Outlaws, when you chant out, oh, you didn't know? Or if, you know, you chant along, what does everybody want? When Al Snow comes out. Those are the kind of things that I think are really easy that, you know, you brings the audience into the show and makes them think they're actually a part of it. I know that WWE honestly hates those fans that think that they become part of the show by being there. But when you bring the whole audience into there, it sort of makes everybody feel, even if you're in the front row or you're sitting in the 300s, that, you know, you're part of the show and you're there for a reason. You could be sitting at home on your couch watching, but you wanted to be there because you wanted to feel those moments. And I think that, you know, No Way Jose, I think, is one of those guys that gets me into the mood to watch him wrestle, no matter how stupid it is. And I think I can only think of one, him winning one match that I've seen since coming to the main roster. But, you know, we're going to look at this. I think that, honestly, coming in, Braun Strowman has to be the huge odds-on favorite to win this match. You've got Colin Jost and you've got Michael Che from Saturday Night Live, who host the weekend update. I don't think that they're going to be using Saturday Night Live other than possibly the night before the event to publicized WrestleMania, so I don't think them showing up on the weekend update set the next week, you know, hyping up what WrestleMania 35 was. I bet they don't even talk about it yet once again, so I don't see them as the guys that's going to win it. When it comes to Braun Strowman, I think they might be doing something with the WrestleMania host. I think that Alexa Bliss, you know, they sort of tried to use her as a negotiator to try and, you know, calm down the tensions because she wanted, you know, her, you know, celebrities from WrestleMania to sort of, you know, slide in together and you know, act as one. And they didn't want them, you know, in a bad place where they felt scared to be there. So they tried to have some sort of a reconciliation, which did not work. Alexa Bliss has been getting her talk show on Monday Night Raw. She has been wrestling on house shows, but they haven't been having her actually wrestle on television for some reason. And some people think that they're actually just trying to build her up as a character. A lot like, you know, she wrestled in NXT, and then when she became a manager to Blake and Murphy is when she really got on the rise. She started to wrestle again. She didn't really get that big of a build. But then once she hit the main roster, she took off like crazy. So I think that they're just trying to sort of develop that character a little bit more, maybe add a little bit to it, because it seems like she's done everything there is to do as a heel by winning the SmackDown Championship countless times, winning the Raw Championship countless times, that they can really go up from there. So that is one direction they could be going. We look at this list, Andre Cien Almas. I don't see him as the guy who's going to win the Andre the Giant Memorial Battle Royal, but I would put money on him as to be a guy that is not going to be in this match come next year. I really thought that, you know, after the Superstar call-ups, when they did the Superstar shake-up, I thought that he was going to be in the main event by SummerSlam. And, you know, he did have some good matches against guys like AJ Styles and Daniel Bryan, Rey Mysterio. He hasn't really caught fire yet, but it's got to be coming sooner than later. Apollo Crews is somebody I always root for, but, you know, he did have a really good match against Kurt Angle, as well as he was one of the guys that came out and helped Braun Strowman at TLC. Doesn't look like right now is going to be his time, though. Titus O'Neil, Tyler Breeze, Jinder Mahal, No Way Jose are all jokes. Bobby Roode and Chad Gable coming off of the tag titles that they've held, I believe, twice. I don't see them as guys that are actually going to win this match as well. Gable, the sooner they figure out that they could use this guy as a single, the more stock he's going to have in WWE. Kalisto, Grand Malik, Lynn Storato, Bo Dallas, Kurt, I didn't even know the B team was still around. I can't even remember. I thought that maybe Bo Dallas or Kurt Axel coming down with an injury. You can remember them winning the Raw tag team titles out of the middle of nowhere. And they had a little bit of a run, but I don't even know if they're on TV anymore. Heath Slater and Rhino, the team that will never go away. Victor and Connor, they seem like they're going to do something with those guys in the tag teams, and they just they like get scared and pull up. Ali is somebody that people are thinking could be a favorite to win this match because of the fact he was sort of scheduled to be in the Elimination Chamber, and sort of his injury, which led to the rise of Kofi Kingston. He hasn't really been able to accomplish that push that he was getting before then. I just don't really see Ali as somebody who's going to eliminate somebody from the Battle Royal, even as the last guy. So that's why I wouldn't pick him. There's 205 Live guys, he's not there anymore. I don't see them winning Battle Royals. Gallows and Anderson on their way to AEW. They're not going to be winning this. Matt Hardy and Jeff Hardy, kind of a surprise they couldn't find somewhere to put these guys in some sort of a tag match. They're some of those popular guys, and they're going to be battling out. Well, at least with the Saturday Night Live angle, it might not be on the pre-show, but I don't think it's guaranteed. Otis and Tucker, I've never seen these guys wrestle a match, even though they show up on Monday Night Raw once in a while. And I think Otis is the one that is really over with a lot of people. And then EC3 can't get a win on Main Event, not going to get a win at WrestleMania. So that's your Andre the Giant Memorial Battle Royal list. I don't think there's anybody as strong as Braun Strowman that could be pulling this out with a victory, guys.